we are gathering today specifically at this time to mark what's going on in our country. A month ago today, there was the school shooting in Parkland, Florida. And it's unfortunately not the first in our country's history. We hope it will be the last. But what we saw after this event was students banding together and saying, we need to protect ourselves, we need to do more. And today, nationwide, there is a movement for students, mostly in high schools, to, at this time, to walk out of their classes for 17 minutes to honor the lives of the 17 students and teachers that were lost in the shooting. We were thinking what would feel appropriate for us as a middle school, and specifically as a Jewish day school. And a very traditional and Jewish response to tragedy, to these kinds of things, is to be able to learn, right? Our Torah, our texts, our rabbis, these are things that inspire us to do better, to be better people. And we figured we would honor the memory of the people who were lost by having this opportunity to learn together and to take their memory and their legacy as an opportunity for us to move forward and to think about how do we make those lasting changes in our world. So I wanted to begin, you all have a sheet in front of you, I wanted to begin with these few words at the top. Yehi shalom bechelech, shalva be'arbenotayich. So there's a tune that goes to it. So I'm going to say the first part and then you guys will repeat. Yehi shalom, Yehi shalom bechelech, bechelech, shalva, shalva, be'arbenotayich. Yofi, let's see if we can do that first line together. And as we're saying it, what are we asking God for? Yehi shalom bechelech. We're hoping that there will be shalom, peace, in all of your places. Shalva, tranquility and quiet, be'arbenotayich, in all of your spaces and your palaces. So let's try that first part together. Yehi shalom bechelech, shalva be'arbenotayich otam. Yehi shalom bechelech, shalva be'arbenotayich. Yofi. And as we're about to do our learning together, we hope that that idea of peace and shalom and shalva will infuse us as we're doing our learning and will help us move forward today. Mm-hmm. So I've gathered for everybody a couple of different sources that will help us think about what do we do in this moment. The first two are from the Mishnah in Sanhedrin. So I'm going to read the Hebrew. Would somebody like to read the English for us? Okay, Rivka, bevakasha. So here's the first part. Shekein matzinu b'kayim sheharag et achiv sheneemar in Bereishit Dalet demei achicha tzoakim. Eino omer dam achicha, ela demei achicha. Damo v'dam zariotav. Okay? Bakasha, Rivka.
In regard to Cain who killed his brother, the bloods of your brothers scream out.
Okay, so let's pause for a minute, right? Because here we are, we started the book of Vayikra. But we're thinking back to one of the very first stories in Bereishit, and we're thinking of the story of when Cain killed Hebel, right? And we see there's sort of a strange piece in the Hebrew, right? When God comes along and says, you know, what's going on here? It says, "Demei achicha tzoakim." The damim, literally, the bloods of your brother. Well, the rabbis come along and they say, that's strange. Why would you say the word damim, bloods, instead of dam, singular, right? Yachid versus rabim. Why would you do that? Okay. Continue. The verse does not say the blood of your brother, but...
But blood of your brother, because it was his blood and also the blood of his future offspring, screaming out.
Nachon. Right? So the idea is that it's not just the one person that is affected, but all of their future generations to come as well. Lefichach nivra adam yechidi lelamdecha shekol ha-me'aved nefesh echad mi-Yisrael ma'ale alav katuv ki'ilu ibed olam male.
It was for this reason that man was first created as one person, Adam, to teach you that anyone who destroys a life is considered by scripture to have
the whole world, right? Because to think about the future generations that come from that one person, right, it's endless. So according to the rabbis in the Mishnah, how much value was placed on a single human life?
The whole world.
The whole world, right? And why? Why, if Jewish people, is that so important to us?
Because there's only so many Jews in the world, like for the Holocaust, all those lives, we would be so many more millions of Jews in the world if they were there, and each family would have another part in the world for the Jews.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm not.
Well, every person has the ability to choose the world, so the 17 eyes, like 17 things in the world
is that. Right? And I wanted to mention too, we lit a Yahrzeit candle, right? Not everybody who passed away in Hartford was Jewish, right? Some were not, mm-hmm. right? But it's important to us to remember that all lives are sacred and precious, right? Whether they're Jewish, whether they're not, you're right, Herschel, they're a whole world, right? And we light this candle to remind us that each of those lives was important and was special. We're going to move to the second text. Do we have somebody who wants to read English for this one?
ולהגיד גדולתו של הקדוש ברוך הוא, שאדם תובע כמה מטבעות בחותם אחד, וכולן דומים זה לזה. ומלך מלכי המלכים הקדוש ברוך הוא תבע כל אדם בחותמו של אדם הראשון, ואין אחד מהם דומה לחברו. לפיכך כל אחד ואחד חייב לומר, בשבילי נברא העולם.
What,
Adonna?
To express the grandeur of the Holy One, blessed be he. For a man strikes many coins from the same mold, and all the coins are alike. But the king, the king of kings, the holy one, blessed be he, strikes every man from the mold of the first man, and yet no man is quite like his friend. Therefore, every person must say, for my sake, the world was created.
Yes, I know. Right, so if any of you have ever been to the mint and seen how coins are made, right, or really anything, right, there's a mold, right? You go to a factory and there's a specific type. Everything comes out the same. And when you're working in a factory, that's exactly what you want, right? You want to mass produce. You want to make the same thing over and over again, right? And that's what people are able to do. But what is God able to do?
Mishnah,
what's God able to do? How is God different than people? Yes.
He creates the mold.
And
he destroys the mold.
Well, yeah, sometimes. But from what we see here, right, we all come from the same mold. Who was the original person that we all came from?
Adam
HaRishon, right? Right, from the very first. So according to Bereshit, right, we all have this original ancestor. But are we all the same?
No.
No, right? Each of us is different. And the idea is that God is able to use the same mold, but each of us comes out unique, and each of us comes out different and special. And because of that, we're supposed to say, Yishvili Nivra HaOlam. So my question at the bottom is, okay, so if we're supposed to say the world was created for me, well, what responsibilities do we have? What come along with that? If the world was created for us, for each of us individually, then what responsibility, what do we have to do with that?
Mitzvahs, and we have to fulfill the deeds that we're obligated to do from the Torah, and we also have free will, therefore we have to choose the right things to do and the wrong things to do, and like I said before, fulfill all the things that are obligated.
Yeah, right? It's not just an easy thing to just be given the world and say, here you go, right? It's a responsibility that we all have to take it on and do something with that responsibility. How do we work to make it a better place? Ken? Perfect segue. We're going to look at the next text, number 3 on the back of your sheets. So this is one that we have in our student ring. We've looked at it before. And it's that question. So we have this responsibility, but how do we know what to do? And how do we know how to do it? Well, luckily, we have the dugma, the best possible example, right? The things that God has done in the stories of the Torah are the things for us that teach us how to live, right? It says in the Torah, Acharei Hashem Elohim Yechem Telfu. You're supposed to walk after the path of God. But Rabbi Rabbi Chama bar Rabbi Chanina says, how is a person supposed to do that? How can one literally walk in the path of God? Well, if we take a look, we'll see here are four different examples of ways that we can not literally do it, but metaphorically, right? So what are some of the things that we are supposed to do, right? We should follow the midot of the Kadosh Baruch Hu, right? The actions and the attributes that God takes. So for example, when God clothes the naked for Adam and Chava, well, we too are supposed to do that. When God visits the sick, right? For Abraham, who just had his brit milah, God comes and visits, we too are supposed to visit the sick. When, unfortunately, people pass away, right, it is our responsibility and our job to comfort the mourners, right, in the same way that God came to comfort Yitzchak. And again, unfortunately, right, when there is time for burial, it is our job to do it just as God buried Moshe, right? So these are the types of activities that we want to engage in, right, that make us more holy, to take that responsibility seriously and show that we're really trying to make that world a better place. Let's take a look at our last text. Number four is on the second page. And here's where we get to you guys. Right? Because those are big, weighty things to think about doing. Right? How can I do all of those things? Right? How can I go out and visit the sick and comfort the mourners and bury the dead? Right? You guys are kids. Those are not always easy things for you to be able to take on and do. You have a lot of responsibilities and expectations as well. Right? But what we're learning from this movement in Parkland is that really it's kids that we need to be looking to, and you guys are the ones who are able to shape and change the future and make things better. So let's take a look at our last text together. Do I have one more English reader for us? Okay, Shango Bakasha. Amar Rabbi Elazar, Amar Rabbi Chanina, Talmidei Chachamim Marbim Shalom Ba'olam, Shene Emar, V'chol Banaich Minudei Hashem V'rav Shalom Banaich.
Rabbi Eliezer said that Chanina said, Torah school scholars increase peace in the world, as it is said, and all your children,
Banai,
shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of your children. Mm-hmm. If all the children of Israel are taught of the Lord, there will be peace for all.
Okay, so beautiful start, right? If the Banim are able to learn Limudei Hashem, to learn the ways of God, then we would have a more peaceful and wonderful world. Okay? But the rabbis come along and they say, no, we don't have to read the word banaich. We can actually switch out the vowels. Al tikri banaich, ela bonaich. Right? Because it doesn't have vowels, you can read it as a separate word. So Shendel, would you read that for us?
The sages interpreted this verse
homiletically as a midrash.
Mm-hmm. Do not read your children, but your builders, Torah.
So, right, we're not going to read the word banaich, builders, children. Instead, we're going to read the word as bonaich, builders, okay, Torah scholars.
Torah scholars are those who build peace for the generation.
Yes, and Ot, right? So it's these people who are building, literally, bonim, a better world. And here we have some sukkim that are going to help us prove that. Shalom rav lo ohave toratecha ve'ein lamo mishol. Yehi shalom bechelech, shalva be'armanotayich. Back to that song that we sang at the beginning, right? May there be peace within your walls, prosperity within your palaces. Leman achai v'rei'ai, adab rana shalom bach. Leman deit Adonai Eloheinu avak shatov lach, Adonai oz le'amon yiteng, Adonai v'barech et amova shalom. So based on these final texts, right, how do these ancient texts from our tradition help us cope with these tragedies and help us refocus on the kind of world that we want to live in today, right? We decided to take this opportunity not just to leave class, right? It was important to us to mark this moment and mark this event, right? But we decided that it was important for us to learn texts together, right? So how do these texts help us make those kind of changes and impacts? Can
you tell us these builders and change the world?
People can make a difference, right? And not just adults, right? Kids can really make that difference in seeing and fighting for the world that we want. want and that we want to be living in, right? So whatever it is that is dear to you and is passionate to you, we hope that these lessons from the Torah and the rabbis will help you work towards that and achieve that, right? And we are supporting you here at school, and we want you to be able to take on those challenges and make those lasting changes in the world, because we need you to be not only our banim who learn Torah, but also to be our boni, right? The people who are going to build this world into a better place. So I copied the words from one of the other psukim, sets of psukim here at the bottom. There's a tune for these words as well. If you know it, try to sing along with me. If not, you can always sing, nigun as we go. So this one again, we're saying, for the sake of my brothers and friends, we ask for peace, and for the sake of God, we're going to be seeking good.
Lemana chai derei, adabrana, adabrana, shalom bach, leman leitzar, shai elohinu, apak shatola.
So as we're finishing, we'll take just a moment of silence to remember the 17 lives that were lost in Parkland, and unfortunately the other many lives that have been lost in these types of incidents in our country's history. And I hope that as we take that moment of silence, we really have an opportunity to reflect on how each of us is unique and important and has an opportunity to change the world for better. And as we think about these souls, we say, may our memories be for a blessing.